Good morning, everyone. So this is going to be your fourth session on matrices and determinants. This would be the last session. In this session, we are going to primarily deal with product of determinants. We are also going to talk about differentiation and to a certain extent, integration of determinants. And then we are going to talk about the Cramer's rule. That's the method to solve system of linear equations by determinant method. Apart from that, when the time permits, we'll be taking up a little bit of concepts on functions. All right. So let's get started with some problem solving, because last class we did not get enough chance to solve questions. So I would like to begin today's session with some questions. All right. Let's take up this question. Meanwhile, many people have not joined in. They will be joining in. It's a show that question. Show that if x1, x2, x3 are non-zero, then this determinant is given by the right hand side. Okay, I guess everybody has joined in. All right, so let me start discussion for the same question. See, the first thing that I will do is I will write this determinant as sum of two determinants. Okay, so we'll take the left-hand side determinant, x1 plus a1 b1. And we'll write this as okay. So we'll break this up as A1, B1. Let's do one thing. Let's keep the second and the third column as it is. Let's break with respect to the first column. Okay. So I'm doing the splitting with respect to the first column. So let me write it like this. So x1, a1, b2, a1, b3, 0, x2 plus a2, b2, a2, b3, again 0, a3, b2, and x3 plus a3, b3. So as you can see, I am trying to break it with respect to column number 1. So the other component will be A1, B1, A2, B1, A3, B1. And these two columns would remain as they are. No changes in these two columns. Okay. So the first determinant you can expand with respect to column number one. So the first determinant we can expand with respect to column number one because two zeros have been created over here. Right? So let us try to expand the first determinant along column number one. So this will become x1 times x2 plus a2 b2, x3 plus a3 b3, minus a3 b2 a2 b3. Okay. Let's open this up further. This will become x2, x3. You'll also have x2, a3, b3, and you'll also have x3, a2, b2. I think the other term would get cancelled off. The other term would get cancelled off. So there's no need to write it. So ultimately, you'll end up getting x1, x2, x3, x1, x3, a2, b2, and x1, x2, a3, b3. Okay. Now, what about the second determinant? What can you do with the second determinant?
Split again.
Okay. First thing can I do? Can I take b1 common from the first column? Let's take yes. b1 for the first column. So let's do the change here itself so that we don't have to write it again. B1, B1, B1. Okay. Now, as you can see, there is an A1 present over here, and there's an A1 B2, and there's an A1 B3. Okay. Can we do anything to get it cancelled? Can we do this operation? Can we do C2 as C2 minus B2 C1? And in the same way, can I do C3 as C3 minus B3 C1? If I do that operation, this determinant only, I'm writing it, it becomes B1, A1, A2, A3. You'll be left with a zero here, zero here. This will be X2. This will be zero again. This will be zero again. And this will be X3. Okay. I think this is pretty easy for us to expand. We can expand with respect to, let's say, the first row itself. So this will become A1, B1, X2, X3. A1, B1, X2, X3. Okay. Now, altogether, if you see, if you combine this expression and this expression, your expression will be x1, x2, x3. It will be x1, x3, a2, b2. It will be x1, x2, a3, b3. And it will be x2, x3, a1, b1. So you can take now x1, x2, x3 common, and that will give you 1 plus a1, b1 by x1. As you can see, this term will give you a1, b1 by x1. This term will give you a2, b2 by x2. And the final, this term will give you a3, b3 by x3. That's your RHS. That's what you wanted to prove, hence proof. Okay. No problem, Ruchir. Do you want me to explain this again?
It's fine.
Your voice is breaking like anything.
So I'll watch the recording afterwards.
Oh, no problem. Okay. Is this fine? Let's take up the next question. Yeah. You can take this one. If they have given you an identity, the best way to solve this is put some dummy values for A, B, and C. This should be easy. I think you should be able to get this easily. That's correct, Param. Vikas, I think some sign mistake has happened. Correct, Mahit. Okay, so I'll do it in two ways. One is by use of regress method. So let's take up a regress method first. The first operation that I would do here is, first I will change R2 by using this operation, R2 minus R3. when I do that operation, I'll end up getting a 4A over here. Okay, so take 4 out common. Take a 4 out common. Okay. Next operation that I would do is I will do R3 as R3 minus R1 plus 2R2. Okay, so minus R1 because I want to get rid of A square term. Plus 2R2 because I want to get rid of A term. So that will leave you only with 1, 1, 1, right? So this will become A square, B square, C square, A, B, C, 1, 1, 1. Now, if you just swap the position of these two, you'll end up getting 4, 1, 1, 1, A, B, C, A square, B square, C square, but with a minus sign over here. Okay. What is I here?
So I meant K.
K, no, no. K is not A. 8, it's minus 4. Okay, now this is a well-known determinant for us. It's one of the determinants which I asked you to keep in your mind. So it's A minus B, B minus C, C minus A. If you compare it with the given expression, this term is going to be your K. Okay, that's one way to do it. Another way to do it is take A as 0. Take A as 0. Okay. Take B as 1. Okay. And take C as minus 1. Okay. Make sure you don't take any one of them to be equal. Else what will happen? Zero will become equal to zero and K will be lost somewhere. Right? So you'll not be able to get the value of K. So when you do that, A is zero and B is one. So it'll become 0, 1, 1. This is one. This is four. This is again a zero. This is one. This is zero. And this is four. This you're comparing with K times A minus B. A minus B is minus 1. B minus C. B minus C is 2. And C minus A. C minus A is again a minus 1. Okay. So you can expand this if you want. Let's expand with respect to the last column. Plus minus plus. So it's 0 minus 4 plus 4 minus 1. So you'll get 2k is equal to this. That means minus 8 is equal to 2k. So k is equal to minus 8. Minus 4, sorry. Simpler way to do it. Is that fine? Any questions here? Oh, you did a sign mistake. No worries. Let's take another one. I hope you can read the question here. Slightly darkened it has become on this side, but I think so. If summation alpha n from n equal to 1 till n is an square plus bn, a and b are constants, and alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 belong to okay. And 25 alpha 1, 37 alpha 2, 49 alpha 3 be 3 digit numbers, then prove that this is equal to 0.
So it's 5, 7, 9, right?
Five, seven, nine.
So in the determinant, like the marker is on that, yeah.
If you know that there is a summation which is giving you a quadratic in n without a constant term. I hope you remember we had a discussion on this in the series sequence progression chapter last year. This can only happen if your sequence alpha n is an AP. Only in an AP you would see that you'll end up getting a quadratic, and that too without a constant term. If you just try to check it with the expression itself, you would realize that this expression would always be a quadratic without any constant term. I mean, there will not be a C kind of a term. There'll always be n square and n containing term. Correct. Done, Ruchir. Very good. Okay. Now look at this expression. Look at this expression. First of all, I can comment alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. They're claiming it to be single digited numbers. Okay, very good. Can I also say that alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3 will be in AP? Okay, since the entire series, in the entire sequence is in AP, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 will also be in AP. And how to use this information that these are three digited numbers. Because I can see 557799 and alpha 3. Basically, what they are trying to hint at, if you do this operation, R3 as R3 minus 10 times R2 minus R1. Basically, this number would be like, I just take a guess. Let's say it is 252. I'm just taking an example. Okay, because alpha 1 is a single digited number. If you do this operation, that means if you're subtracting 50 minus 2, it will leave you with 200, isn't it? So when I do this operation, the entire last row will become 200. This will become 300. And this will become a 400. Correct? Yes or no? Now, when such a thing arises, it's a very big sigh of relief because you can do...
Wait, sir, I didn't get this. Why does 49A3 have to be bigger than 400?
Sorry?
So why does 49 alpha 3 have to be more than 400?
It's not a product. It's not a product. These are numbers.
Oh.
Yeah, it is just a positioning of alpha 1 there. It is not like 25 into alpha. It is not like
that. Oh, okay. So I thought it was... Okay, fine.
No, it is not product. Yeah. So first of all, let's take 100 common from the last column. I think it won't make much of a difference to us, but just for this thing. And then we can do this operation. C2 as C2 minus C1 plus C3 by 2. So when I do that, remember, since they are in AP, alpha 1 plus alpha 3 is equal to 2 alpha 2. Okay. So you are subtracting, you are doing this operation in the middle row. You are doing alpha 2 minus alpha 1. Alpha 1 plus alpha 3 by 2. That will give you a 0, isn't it? So alpha 1, alpha 3, there will be a 0. Similarly, 7 minus 14 by 2 will also be 0. This will also be 0. So I think the entire column number 2 has vanished. That means this determinant, even though multiplied with 100, it will give you 0 into 100. That's 0. Is the idea clear? Any questions, anybody here?
So only that the way they represented it got confusing.
No, but they have written no B3 digit. Oh, acha. Yeah. Some of you thought that even after making a product, it is a 3-digit number.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Oh. That's why I thought that alpha 1 has to be.
I agree with you. They could have written the question much better way. Okay. Next, we are going to talk about multiplication of determinants, product of determinants. Achha, one question normally comes in several of the exams, let me ask you this question. Find the largest value. Find the largest value of an order three determinant. Of an order three determinant whose elements are only 0 and 1. Whose elements can only be 0 and 1. I've seen this question coming in many competitive exams. I would like you to try this out. Yes, Mehul. Yes, correct. Correct here. Correct, Ruchir. Correct, Chaitanya. Correct, Advik. Okay. So most of you are giving the right answers to this. Correct, Dhruv. Dhruv, how are you now? How are you feeling now? Things under control? Okay. Don't worry, you are strong enough. Okay, so if you just take, correct Varun, if you take basically any, let's say I take any determinant in general, which is of order three. Let's say I take this. Why am I writing three? Okay, so if I take this determinant and if I expand it, I'm sure you would have done the Saras method also. Let me expand this with respect to Saras method. So A1, let's write here itself without wasting much time. A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. Okay, so if you use the Saras method, okay, what you will have, on the right side, R is equal to A1 B2 C3 plus A3 B1 C2 plus A2 B3 C1. And the left side would be these terms. Let me choose green color. So this will be A3 B2 C1 plus A1 B3 C2 plus A2 B1 C3. And your determinant is actually found by doing this operation R minus L. R minus L. Okay. Now, if you want this guy to have a maximum value, can I say all those ones in the R should be 1? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Correct. And all those in the L, we should try to have it as a 0.
Yes, sir.
Correct. So if you if you take A1, B2, C3 and A3, B1, C2 and A2, B3, C1 all as one, that means each one of them has to be one. Correct? No?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So the elements in these positions, and what about these? They should all be zero, right?
One of any of those elements should be zero.
Sorry?
So like for each of them to be zero, either one or two or all three should be zero.
Correct.
So what we can instead do is just make one of these three guys zero. We can make A2, B3, C1 zero by making all three zero. Then all of your left hands become zero.
I didn't get you.
So we can sacrifice one of the right hand guys to make all the left zero.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to see. So if I make all of them as one, then I'll have such kind of scenario that A1, I'll just try to write it down. Let's say A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. I think everything will be getting covered.
We'll give you a zero determinant.
Yeah. Right? And yes, this will give me a zero determinant. So what I have to do is I have to sacrifice one of them. Let's say if I sacrifice A1 and make it zero. Okay, let's say I make this a zero. Okay. So this will become a zero. Okay, and this will become a zero. And let's say I make B2 a zero. So B2 is zero is not coming up over here. So this will become a zero. Okay. And let's say I make C3 a zero. C3 is also not coming here. So this will become 1, 1, 0. That means the largest possible value of the determinant that you can obtain from this is actually, let's expand this. So it's -1, -1, +1, 1. So that means 2 is the largest value you can get. Okay. Is this fine? So this is a question that normally comes in many competitive exams. So this is how we have to deal with it. Next concept that we are going to talk about is product of determinants. Is product of determinants. Or you can say multiplication of determinants of the same order. Now, the first question that arises, why do we need to learn product of determinants? Aren't these two simple numbers which we can multiply anyhow? So why do we need to learn a rule for finding the product of determinants? There are certain questions that you would get that would be solved only when you try to break up a determinant as product of two determinants. It's not that this process is important. It's actually this process which is important. Breaking a determinant, let's say breaking a determinant D3 as product of D1 and D2. So sometimes breaking a complicated determinant into simpler determinants, which can be easily be evaluated, that is more desired rather than learning how to multiply two determinants to get a third one. So why we are learning this concept is primarily because of this. Now, how do we multiply determinant? I hope you remember, how do we multiply matrices? How do we multiply matrices? Let's say I talk about two matrices which are of the same order. Let's say two square matrices. How do we multiply it? We normally take the row of this and multiply it with the column of this. Okay, this is the symbol that we follow. So it's basically row into column multiplication that we do. Okay, so this is true for a matrices. This is true for a matrices. But for a determinant, there is no such rule like this. You can do row with row. You can do row with column as you do it in matrices. You can do column with row. You can do column with column. End result is going to be the same anyhow. Let me take an example to illustrate this. Let's say I take 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I want to multiply this determinant, let's say with 2, 1, 0, let's say 3. Okay. Now, we all know that the answer coming from here should be minus 2 into 6, isn't it? Answer should be minus 12. Now, I'll show you that I'll obtain a determinant whose value will be minus 12, irrespective of whether I do row with column, column with row, column with column. Now see, let's say I do this operation, row with row. So let me take a row with row operation. So when you do row with row operation, you take the first row and you multiply it with the first row of the second determinant. So 1 will multiply to 2, 2 will multiply to 1, and that would come in the first row, first column position. Okay. Then you take the first row, multiply it with the second row, and that you can write either in this position or in this position. That's your call. Okay. So let's say I write it in this position here. So this will become 0 plus 6, which is 6. Similarly, this row multiplies with this will give you a 10. Correct me if I'm wrong. And this row multiply this will give you a 12. Okay. If you evaluate this, you'll get 48 minus 60. That's nothing but a minus 12. That's what was expected. If you do row with column, the result would be no different. Let's see. Row with column means the same way as you do the matrix multiplication. So this with this, so that will give you 2. Okay. This with this will give you a 7, I believe. This with this will give you a 6. This with this will give you a 15. So this is going to be 30 minus 42, again a minus 12. Okay, no change in the answer whatsoever. If you do column with row, that also I'll show you. So column with row means take the column and multiply with the row. Okay, so this column multiply with first row will give you a 5, if I'm not wrong. Okay, this with 5. And this with this will give you a 9, that you can write here also, no worries. This with this will give you 8. Correct? And this with this will give you a 12. Am I right? So this will give you 60 minus 72, which is again a minus 12. Okay. If you do column with column also, nothing will change. So this column with the first column will give you a 2. This column with this column will give you a 10, I believe. This column with this column will give you a 4. And this column with this column will give you a 14. So it's 28 minus 40, again a minus 12. Okay. So in determinant multiplication, you can follow any of these four rules without affecting your result. Okay. Now, where is it used? How is it used? We'll come to know when we take few questions here. When we take few questions over here. Let us say somebody gives you a question like this. There's a determinant. There's a determinant given by A1 alpha 1, B1 beta 1, A1 alpha 2, B2 beta 2. I think this should be B1 beta 2, I think, because it's not following the trend. And then it's A1 alpha 3, B1 beta 3. This will be A2 alpha 1, B2 beta 1. Let's say A2 alpha 2, B2 beta 2. A2 alpha 3, B2 beta 3. And finally, you have A3 alpha 1, B3 beta 1, A3 alpha 2, B3 beta 2, A3 alpha 3, B3 beta 3. My question is, prove that this determinant is 0. Prove that this determinant is 0. Okay. Now, let me solve this question for you, because then you'll get an idea about how to approach in these kind of problems. Okay. Param is already done. Okay, Param. Good. So what I will do is I will envisage this determinant as product of two determinants. So I will try to envisage this as the product of two determinants. And let me tell you, this is not easy. If at all a student feels problem in determinants, it is this concept where he feels the determinant. He tries to try all possible ways, and then later he realizes that, oh, nothing is working. So probably I should try giving it, try breaking it as a product of two determinants. So it doesn't come very easy. Okay. This topic of product of determinants is not easy. Okay. Now, if you look at these trends, you'll always see A1, B1, A1, B1, A1, B1. So what is happening? Let me take A1, B1 over here. Okay. Now, this guy is multiplying with some determinant to produce this. So if alpha 1, beta 1 has to come, there has to be alpha 1, beta 1. Okay. Now, what about this element and this element? Okay. As of now, I'm not sure about any one of them, but at least one of them has to be zero, because let's say I take this as zero. Because when you're multiplying only A1 alpha 1, B1 beta 1, let's say I'm following row with row multiplication. So only A1 alpha 1 plus B1 beta 1 is appearing. That means the other one is getting zero because of one of them being zero, or at least one of them being zero. Okay, so as of now, I'll take one of them as zero. I may have to come back and change it. See, I'm ready to do that, because it's just trying to work it in a reverse direction. I'm doing reverse engineering over here. This may be something, I don't know, but one of them has to be zero. So I've taken a leap of faith and I've called this a zero. Again, I'm repeating it. I may have to come back and change it. Okay. Next, I have A1, B1. And alpha to beta to multiplied to it. That means this guy has to be alpha to beta to for sure. Because then only A1 alpha 2 plus B1 beta 2 will appear. And this could be anything. Okay, this could be anything. Okay, similarly for this, it will be alpha 3 beta 3. And this could be anything. Okay. What about this element? This element will only come when there's an A2 B2 and there is a zero. Now, any one of them could be zero, actually, but let's say this is zero for us, because since we have already taken a zero over here, no need to waste time taking a zero here. Similarly, A2 alpha 2 B2 beta 2 zero will come. That is this element. Similarly, this element will come from A2 alpha 3 B2 beta 3 and zero again. Similarly, this will be A3 B3 and zero, because then only I'll get A3 alpha 1 and B3 beta 1, and same for this. Now, I'm not saying these question marks. Yeah, I'm not saying these question marks are all the same. They may be different also. They may be zero also. I mean, you don't know. But I don't care about it, because one of the columns here is completely zero. Right? If it is completely zero, that means this entire determinant will collapse. And whatever is the other determinant, whatever is the other determinant, it will give you a zero itself. That means your result is zero.
So, but here, what if like one of the zeros I can replace with the two question marks?
Question marks. Okay. That's one of the question that arises. Let's check whether that can happen. Okay. If let's say, okay, now try multiplying this guy with this guy. That means focus on this term. There should be an answer coming from this and this. Correct? So there should be an extra term coming from here, there. But there is no extra term.
Yes. And you can't put it anywhere else.
Can't put it anywhere else, yes. Yeah. So that violates the fact that there cannot be a switching off. One of them has to be having all the columns as zero. I'm just replacing it back else. Yeah. Is that fine? Let's take more questions. I think as we solve more and more questions, the concept would be cleared. I'm sorry, this slightly looks like a deviated. This is your first column. This is your first column. This is your second column. And this is your third column. I think there was no space. That's why they wrote it below. But I hope you can read this out, right? Prove that this determinant is a zero. Okay, Ruchir, very good. Both the Ruchirs. Okay, let's try to predict. Let's try to predict which two determinants would give you this determinant. So let's try to predict that. Okay, Pranav. Okay. So, see, you have a 2 here. Okay. And you have alpha plus beta plus gamma plus delta, and you have alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Okay. So, let's try to predict. See, I can just take a leap of faith. I may be wrong. Okay. Let me tell you, there may be errors in it. So, I may have to come back and revisit my working also. Okay. So, okay. Let's take this as 1-1. Okay. Let's take this also as 1-1. Now, since there is no other, that means let's say this is 0 and this may be something. I don't know what is it. So, at least I can put a 2 over here. Okay. Next is alpha, beta, gamma, delta. I cannot have alpha, beta, gamma, delta because it's a 3x3 determinant. That means
alpha plus beta, gamma plus delta.
Yeah, and I can see these kind of pairing ups are also happening. Okay, there's a pairing up of these terms happening. So let's say I take this as alpha plus beta and I take this as gamma plus delta. Gamma plus delta. Okay, and this may be anything. I don't care because the zero here will take care, and hence I have got this term also. For this term, similarly, I can say alpha, beta, gamma, delta, and I don't care whatever is here. Okay. Now let's choose the element of the second row for the first determinant. Remember, second row multiple. This is also taken care. Second row, first row here will give you this element. Okay. So can I, let's say I take alpha plus beta, gamma plus delta. Okay.
It should be the other way.
And this will be zero. We'll check. If things go wrong, we'll check. Ah, yes. Ruchir is absolutely correct. Because when you multiply this with the second row, I should get alpha plus beta whole square, gamma plus delta whole square. But this is not the element which is sitting over here. So yes, you are absolutely correct. It should be the other way around. See, this is what I was saying. You may have to revisit it. It's not that you have put and it will be some writing in stone.
Okay. Same thing here. Be gamma, delta, alpha.
And this, with this will give you this. This will give you this and zero. So that's correct. Okay. So this element is also taken care of. No worries with this. Now here, let's say I take alpha, beta and gamma, delta, then yes, that will create a problem. Yeah. So let's take gamma, delta and alpha, beta and a zero. So this with this, this with this and zero with this will give you this element. This with this, this with this and this with a zero will give you this element. And this will give you two alpha, beta, gamma, delta. This will. Yeah. So this is the right way to do it. And since one of them is completely having the third column as zero, so it's a zero column. So everything will become a zero here. Zero into anything will give you a zero. Got the point? Any questions?
Yes, sir.
Next. Show that this determinant is always non-negative. When is this determinant zero?
Sir, this method of like splitting the determinant, can we like, we can also use it to like normally solve determinants, right?
See, no, if it's like integration by parts. If you can normally solve it, do it. Right. If you think it cannot be solved by any other method, and then you figure out, okay, it's not like if you're not able to solve it by any other method, your product will of determinants will work definitely. No, not like that. It may work. So even give that a try. Probably that may work. So there is no like rule that if anything doesn't work, if you have to apply product of determinants, you may feel that. Easy determinants can also be written as a product. But as you can see, it is not easy. You have to do some reverse. You have to do a guesswork. It's a reverse engineering that is happening.
Yes.
Yeah, this is going to be a simple integration, actually. Simple determinant, actually. Okay, let's say I want to write this as a product of two determinants. Let's say I can solve it other way also, but let's say I want to write it. Can I write it? Let's try to check. Can we write it as a product of two determinants? I see a square, b square, c square. Okay, so let's have ABC, ABC. Okay, that will definitely generate, correct? Yeah, that will definitely generate a square, b square, c square. Next, I want BC, CA, AB. So there's a C here. So I can have a B. So AB will be generated. C, BC will be generated and A. Okay. Similarly, this I can write it as CAB also. No problem will happen. Same term will be generated. Okay. For this, I can have again BCA. Check it out. Okay. And I think everything else will work fine. See, this element can also be obtained when you multiply this with this. Okay, so if you want this element to happen, that means there has to be CAB here also. And just check if every element is fine. Basically, you're writing the cyclic determinant whole square. Right, you're writing the cyclic determinant whole square. So you are writing ABC, BCA, CAB the whole square. So this can never be negative. It is always a greater than equal to zero quantity. Now we have also learned that the expansion of this determinant is this. Okay. If you want this to be zero, remember the factorization of this was half a plus b plus c, a minus b whole square, b minus c whole square, and c minus a whole square. Okay. So under two situations, it will give you zero. One, your a plus b plus c should be zero, and two, your a, b, c could all be equal to each other like this. Correct? So they will all be equal, then also it will be zero. Need not be all zero actually, because it need not be all zero. So if they're equal or their sum is zero, then only they will be zero. Got it? Any questions here? Okay, let's take more questions. Okay, I'll help you out in this.
Just 1 minute, sir.
Okay. Let me at least expand this and write so that we can. This is BC, B plus CX, X square. Okay. Yeah. Can we envisage this as a product of?
So first, could we start by like subtracting some of the rows?
Some of the rows. Okay, a good idea.
So like you can, yeah. Row two is equal to row two minus row one. And row three is equal to row
okay. three. So what one. I plan is basically Param, when I look at this right side expression, okay. This expression looks very familiar to me because I have seen this in one of these determinants, which basically I keep on using 1, 1, 1, A, B, C, A square, B square, C square. This is what I think this will, you know, help me to get it. Same with this guy. Okay. I plan it to break it like this so that, you know, directly these two determinants, which I'm encircling with yellow and green, they come directly. I think when you do that subtraction, you will end up getting few factors directly out, which yes, I can do, but I'm avoiding it right now. Okay. Let's see. I may have to, you know, come back and do whatever you are saying, but let's try to see what best we can do. Okay. So let's say I want to get this element. Okay. And in the back of the mind, those two determinants are also running in here. So can I do one thing? I can definitely see one X and X square. So let's keep this one X and X square, and let me keep this as BC, B plus C and a one. Let's not put brackets unnecessarily. Okay. Right. Correct.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now for this element, let's choose AC, A plus C and 1 over here. And for this element, let's choose AB, A plus B, 1. I may be wrong. I may have to come back and change it. Okay. So I'm just taking a leap of faith as of now. So I think these three elements have been taken care of. So for this, I need to multiply the first row with the second row here. So it has to have 1, 1, Y square. And thankfully, not only this is also falling in place when you multiply second row of the first determinant with the second row of the second. And when you multiply third row with the first determinant with the second row of the second. So these two are falling in place. So now this multiplied with 1 Z and Z square will do the wonders. So this will be obtained when the first row multiplies with the third. Then again, second row multiplies with the third, I'll get this. Again, third row multiplies with this, I'll get this. Okay, so everything is falling in place. And thankfully, this determinant is known to be X minus Y, Y minus Z, Z minus X. So at least I got that a green circle part, which I was trying to obtain. I hope I'm correct. Yeah. Okay, what about this? What about this? What about this? What about this? Yeah. Can we do a simplification of this? I think we can take one of the rows, subtract it from the other two rows. Or would you like to split this up and do it? Yeah, we can split this up and do it. So let's try that because it won't be that difficult. So let's say BC, AC, AB. B, A, splitting will not be that great. Okay, let's expand it. So let's do this operation, R1 as R1 minus R3 and R2 also as R2 minus R3. So this will be BC minus AB. I think C minus A will be left. Zero. AC minus AB. C minus B will be left. Zero. AB, A plus B, one. I think C minus A can be taken out from here, and C minus B can be taken out from here. So C minus A, C minus B. Correct. So if you expand it now with respect to the third column, this should give you just B minus A. So you'll end up getting B minus A. Let me write it as A minus B and switch this position, B minus C and C minus A. And you already had this term. Let's copy it. So your final answer would be this into X minus Y, Y minus Z, Z minus X. Done. Clear? Any questions here? Clear, Abhiram? Abhiram nowadays is not answering. What happened, Abhiram? You have gone very quiet. All well? Abhiram, you're there?
I don't lie, I understood.
Huh?
Yes, sir, I understood.
Oh, okay. I think the frequency of your answering has reduced. Yeah. This we have already done. We'll take one more. Let me just take up one more. Let's take this question. Prove that. A minus X whole square, A minus Y whole square, A minus Z whole square, B minus X whole square, B minus Y whole square, B minus Z whole square, C minus X whole square, C minus Y whole square, C minus Z whole square is equal to 2 times B minus C, C minus A, A minus B is actually slightly wrong, times X minus Y, Y minus Z, Z minus X.
So could you show the right side of it? Yes, sir.
Done. Chaitanya also done. Good. Very good. Most of you have been able to do this. So if you expand this and write, I think I need more space. It's not be sufficient. Yeah.
So the property, the b minus c, a minus b, b minus c, c minus a, that works only for a particular order.
Which I didn't get you.
Like in the determinant, which we generally expand, it's like 1, 1, 1, x, y, z, and x square, y square, z, z. Does it work only for that?
Yeah, it works only for that.
Okay.
Or if you are able to substitute something with y, z, x, y, z.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so this is b square minus 2bx plus x square, b square minus 2by plus y square. This is b square minus 2bz plus z square. Okay. Now let's try to write this as a product of two determinants. Okay. So let's say this element. Can I just take a square minus 2a and 1 and keep 1x x square here? Correct? Similarly, I can keep 1y, y square here and 1z, z square here. I think this determinant will take care of the last three factors that we have on the right hand side. Okay, what about this? This has to be b square minus 2b1. This has to be c square minus 2c1. I think everything will fall in place when you multiply these two determinants. Just take a minus 2 out. Just take a minus
2. So we already have the result for the determinant.
Not exactly. We have to switch. This result is known to us. We have to
switch. Yeah, one switch will give a minus sign.
We have to switch this first. Yeah. So when we switch this first, we'll end up getting, let me just change in the next step, 2, 1, 1, 1, a, b, c, a square, b square, c square. I think this term would be the one responsible for the first three factors that we have on our right hand side. Okay. So yes, I think post this, we already know the result. This is a minus b, b minus c, c minus a. This is x minus y, y minus z, z minus x. Done. Okay. Is that fine? Any questions here?
Can you explain how to remove the minus sign again?
Which one? Minus sign.
Yes, sir.
How I removed it? I swapped the position of C3 and C1. No, you can only write this result when it is 1, 1, 1, A, B, C, A square, B square, C square in the same order, either row wise or column wise.
Yes, right? Sir.
But here it was a slight deviation in the pattern. That's why I flipped the position and removed this negative sign from it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Great, guys. Then I think we are good to go with differentiation of a determinant. Enough questions we have taken on this. Differentiation of a determinant. Differentiation of a determinant.